Today, I am answering the question, how can I use my book to get clients? Now, here's the thing. By the end of this episode, you are going to know how, whether you are an entrepreneur, whether you are a coach, whether you are a consultant, how you can write something that will make you money, because you are never going to make money from your book sales. You just are not. Maybe you are. Hey, J.K. Rowling. Hey, Simon Sinek. Whoever. Glennon Doyle. Some, yes. Very, very few of us. So instead of trying to do something that is almost impossible, think about how you can strategically use your book to make money not from book sales. So I'm going to explain to you what I mean by this. My first book, Party Girl, I wrote it as a novel, a novel about my addiction. Yet, because it is about addiction and recovery, it has ended up getting me clients. It got me a celebrity coaching client who listened to the book and reached out to me and said, I want you to be my coach. And I said, I'm not a coach. And he said, I don't care. I want the author of that book. And that is what you want people to say. I want the author of that book. So you have to write whatever that book is in your field. So I suggest working backwards. Don't do what I did, which was have it accidentally happen. Be very strategic. Say, okay, I have a business where I help blank people blank. Whatever that is, you need to educate your future client or customer. And maybe your book explains why. Let's say you help people with branding. Maybe it is a book about why branding is so important. I'll tell you, for my recent book, Make Your Mess Your Memoir, what I did is I pictured two people I knew. They're a couple who I had talked to about, they talked to me about hiring my company to write and publish their book. And I thought, I want to use this book as a lead magnet to get these two people as clients. And the reason that I did that isn't that I was thinking small, it's that I was thinking big. I was thinking about the Kevin Kelly idea of 1,000 true fans. And how you do not need the masses. You need a niche. So I used to think books should be, I'll write them for everybody. No. Think about your ideal client. So as I was writing Make Your Mess Your Memoir, I thought about this couple every page. I was like, would he like that? Would she be shocked by that? Whatever it was. I finished the book. I will tell you a secret. They haven't even read it. They certainly haven't hired me, but I've brought in hundreds of thousands of dollars in business from people that are just like them. It's sort of like on Facebook, the lookalike audience. Your ideal client is an avatar, and if there's one, there's many. So I wrote this book about how to make your mess into your memoir because I wanted to help show people how to do that. But I also knew by showing people that I was the expert in how to do that, they would then want to hire me. So one of the things that I always recommend is if you have a book that is designed to get you clients or customers, it's like having a book that's designed to get you speaking gigs. You can't write the book, publish it, and just sort of be like, okay, cool. Who's going to call me and ask if they can hire me? It doesn't really work like that. I got a lucky break on this one, and I got on Good Morning America. And so that sort of skyrocketed it allowed me to skip what I'm about to tell you I was planning to do. You know, because people have a lot of misconceptions. When I got on GMA, I got an email from a publicist that randomly said that appearance was worth $250,000. Now, you might think, wow, that must mean she sold a lot of books. I think I sold 1,000 books that weekend, and that was with a lot of other efforts. I probably sold a handful from Good Morning America. But what it is, the handful that bought it then hired me. So it's not about how many books you sell. It's about who is buying it and who is reading it. So I will tell you, one of my business mentors is someone named Alan Weiss. He is amazing. Go follow him if you don't already. He wrote a book called Million Dollar Consulting. Now, I first heard him on a podcast. I heard him on Noah Kagan's podcast. And I then read his book, Million Dollar Consulting. I then went to one of his seminars. I paid to go to this week-long seminar called 6 to 7. It was about bringing your business from six figures to seven figures. The reason I'm telling you this is that Alan put up at the front of when we all sat down, it's 40 people around a conference table, and he said, how did you hear about me? Because we were people from all over the world. And he made a list, and number one was book. So one person says, I read your book. He writes down book. Oh, one person says, I saw your YouTube video. One person says, I heard you on this radio show. 99% of people were there because we had read his book. And I actually took a picture of this and I will put it in the show notes just so you can see how valuable it is. My point is that a book can absolutely get you clients, but you have to work it. The trick I learned from Alan Weiss, and he actually writes about this in Million Dollar Consulting. He says, when you write a book, sit down and think about who is your ideal client. Then you think about everyone you know. And then you think, now, could, you know, John Smith know my ideal client? Basically, you go through your, what old people call Rolodex, what current people say is your address book on your phone. And you think about who you know who might know people, because if you do something for a living, or if you want to do something for a living, you want to coach people about how to be healthy with money, you want to coach mothers about how to be healthy with their children, you know people who will pay you money to do that. So what Alan recommends, and I always recommend to my clients, is take two copies of your book, sign both, have a person you're sending it to, somebody you know whose address they've given you, send them both copies. And that is because nobody throws away a signed book. People rarely throw away books, don't tell people, but like most people don't throw away books. They really don't throw away signed books. And anyone you know who is a prospective client, they know someone who's a prospective client. So now you've got two prospective clients. So these techniques, they work for no matter what your business is. At Launchpad, we have published books by a sports agent, by a recovery coach, by a somebody who owns a nonprofit, by somebody who sells to the government. You know, we published 20 books and we have 20 more scheduled to come out. So it's every aspect of business. And it blows my mind that it works for all of them. I first learned this from my client, Darren Prince, the sports agent. He puts out this book about aiming high, go get it, it's awesome, about his addiction and recovery. And I think, oh, this is really sweet. He really wants to help people. He does. He started an aiming high nonprofit, all the things. Next thing I know, he's getting offered six-figure spokesperson deals. He's getting paid $10,000 to go speak around the world. But what he told me, which is really interesting, is that it brought in so much more business to his sports agency, because when he sat down with people, they knew they had read his book about addiction, or if they knew he had done it, and it was less a business meeting as two friends kind of hanging out. And when you're two friends hanging out, you know what? The negotiations are going to go a lot better than when you're business acquaintances. There are all sorts of, I've had an MBA angel investor whose book we're publishing. We're just, basically what I will do when I bring on a client, I don't want to take money from anybody who isn't going to earn back at least 10 times what they're paying me. So if somebody says to me, like this client says, I'm an angel investor and I want to write a book. And I go, okay, great. Let's figure out what your business is. And so we came up with this idea that basically she has an MBA. Like I said, she's an angel investor. So she's starting a company where she's going to help women build their businesses, whether there'll be two tiers, one for the ones just starting out who need to know, like, what's an LLC, what's an S-Corp, what's a DBA, how do I incorporate? And then the other tier, which is how do I write a business plan? How do I get investors? So my point is, no matter what it is you know how to do, you can build a business around it and you can write a book that will help build that business. But you just gotta hustle it once you write it. I don't recommend, a lot of people will write a book and they'll say, oh, I'm gonna create courses. I find that the course building market is super saturated and it's really hard to get people not only to buy your courses, but to take them. How many courses have you bought that are just sitting there and you're like, I'm gonna sign in and I'm gonna take that I've got a lot myself. But so I don't recommend, I don't think creating courses is the way to gold for any of us. I think it is building a business around your expertise, writing a book that supports that business, and then getting that book into the hands of the people who will pay you to do that. So I hope that helps. Please go grab the show notes. If you're watching the video for this, hit a like, check out another video that I've created on building a business with your book. And if you're listening, my God, I love you. Thank you so much. And I will see you/talk to you next week.